So very basic things are explained here, you know, set of symbols, string. What is string? I think you all know, right? String. So what is language? Set of string. A language is nothing but a set of string, right? And formal language, when you say, so language accepting by an automata is called, known as formal language. So what automata means that I was telling you, right? So if you have a language and for which you can develop an automata, that can be some, you know, NFA or DFA, if it is possible, then this language will be called as formal language. Okay. If you can, automation means not only NFDF, sorry, it can be PDA, sorry, PDA, it can be Turing machine, etc. Okay, the language must have a proper set of alphabet and set of grammar rules. Okay, so languages have both the thing, alphabets and grammar rules. So formal language are, you know, looks like this. Some example of the language, formal language are here. So L1 equal to 5. It is a language which is empty language, does not have any string into it. Okay. Then language. Some example that, you know, L2 equal to only A. It have only one string A. Here you can see this language L3 is having three different strings, A, B, A, and B, A, A. And here you can see L4 is another language. A to the power N K, where, sorry, where your this k is greater than 0 and n is a positive integer. Understand? So say k is equal to 2 and n is positive integer is, say, it can be 1 also. So n into k, it is going to give you a to the power 2 into 1 equal to a to the power 2. That means a. Okay. In Chomsky hierarchy, we have already seen. I am not going into this. This is something you can note. You can note this thing. You know how we represent a different kind of language. If there is a regular language, we represent it by regular expression and automation. That means the transition diagram or machine which will accept is called finite automata. If you have context-free language, then you have CFG to represent it. That means context-free grammar. And the automation accepted it is called PDA. Okay, if you have context-sensitive language, then you have CSG, context-sensitive grammar. And LB, lower bound automata, is there to accept it. And you have recursively enumerable language, then you have REG, recursively enumerable grammar, to accept and represent it. For accepting that kind of language, you have Turing machines. Okay. So this is something is very important for our discussion in compiler design. All these conversions you have to do basically. If you have, see, regular language, it can be represented by regular expression. Okay. Now, if you have regular expression, you must have a finite automata corresponding to this. Okay. Now, question is that how to convert regular expression to finite automata. Okay, this is the first thing. finite automata means regular expression to NFA or DFA you need to convert. And another thing you can see here, for all regular expression there will be some DFA or NFA, and NFAs can be converted to DFA. So NFA to DFA conversion we have seen in our previous courses. NFA to DFA is another thing. Again, we are going to study this NFA to DFA and this all these things in this course also. It is our in our syllabus. Then context-free language you are not going to discuss, so I'm just not saying this. Concatenation, I have already told you, here is an example. It's you have a string this and you have another string this. If you concatenate, you can see here 0110 and another string 0000 are concatenated together. Okay. Then in the same way, there is a reverse operation. That means the string is going to be simply reversed, that the last symbol comes to the first position and the first symbol goes to the last position. Okay, then comes the string length. We already understand by mod we represent the length of string, so that is shown here. Okay, then length of concatenation. If you concatenate to string, basically their lengths are going to be added. This is a simple concept, there is nothing to say. Empty string is given by lambda, or sometimes you also give it by epsilon. Okay. So substring concept I have already told you. So any consecutive character, set of character, if you pick up from a string, it is going to be called as substring. Okay. Then prefix and suffix also I was speaking about. See here, so if you have this string A B B A B A A, so if you keep the whole string as suffix, you can say I have a prefix lambda or I have a prefix epsilon. Okay, you can take only A, the first symbol as a prefix. In that case, the remaining symbols will be treated as suffix. Okay, in the same way, you can split that in any from any point. Okay, so if all the symbols you put in the prefix, then you can say I have suffix as lambda. Okay, then this is something many times you see that instead of star or plus on some symbol, you get some number like n, it can be 2 or whatever. It simply says that how many times it repeats. Okay, WW2 means it is representing WW, it is not W square. Okay, so this is what it is. Again, you can see here W2 and say W equal to BAB, so BAB to that 2, which is going to be repeated 2 times. Okay. Star operation I have explained, so I'm not explaining it again. This plus operation also. So yeah, so this is another way of writing. So alphabet plus equal to alphabet star minus the empty symbol. Okay. Example, so what is the complete complement of the language? L equal to A plus. So this is very common and popular question. Okay, this is a language. What is the complement of this language? Do anybody knows this answer? Rishabh said one. Anybody else is having any other answer? Yeah, one is the correct answer. Okay, one is correct answer. Because, you know, this how much information is given, we can assume that in this language there is only the alphabet is only A, and this language accept all the strings. You can look at it, is this A is given by A plus, so it accept all the string and repetition which are generated by repetition of A. It can be only one A, and so on. Okay, that means if you complement, that means if you remove all the string from this language, what remains is only this epsilon. So your complement of this language is going to be this. Okay. Next is So why is not 5? Somebody can question Rishabh that why the answer of my previous question was epsilon, not 5. So there is a difference between 5 and epsilon. If it is 5, that means it is a empty set. There is not even epsilon. Epsilon is not there in 5. Okay? So the empty set is not equal to lambda or epsilon. Okay, so this not equal to thing you have to understand. It's not equal to. Okay, then size of the set, if you say, empty set, that means there is no set, no symbol into A. Okay, or phi, the length of phi set is 0. But if it is set which contains the empty symbol lambda or epsilon, then you can't say that set, the size of the set is 0. The size of the set is 1. But length of the string is 0. Understand? So if you understand this, then this previous question you can answer properly. Okay. And here is an infinite language. I'm not going into this right now. Operation on languages is important here also in our compiler design. So union is something we have already spoken about, right? When you do union of two languages, you can see what happens. So first language is having a set of strings like A, B, A, and second language is having B, B, and A, B. So you can see A, B, and A, B are common. So it is appearing in the result one time and all other are there. So this is what happens when you make union of two languages. Okay, then there is another operation called intersection. So it is basically subtract all the strings which are present in the second language. Okay, but it is a different form, definitely different form, subtraction. So when you do real subtraction, you can see here, so you can say instead of subtraction, for intersection, you can use the word the overlapped string. Okay, AB and AB are overlapped between these two, so AB is the result. Okay, but when you are doing subtraction, you can see here BB and AB are here, so AB, AB cancelled out, but as BB is in the second set, it will not be considered in the result, but whatever else is remaining in the first set, this A and four times A are considered in the result. This is what subtraction of two languages. Okay. So, complement operation. The first question I had asked is regarding complement. What is complement of a language? So all the string possible in the language given by alphabet star or sigma star, this is all possible string. Okay, so it this means all possible string minus L. What remains in your hand is going to be known as the complement of the language. Okay. Then reverse, I have already told you. Clinic closure star or clinic closure also I have discussed. Okay. Positive closure also discussed. Can anybody answer this? Which of the following is true? Every subset of a regular set is regular. Every finite subset of a non-regular set is regular. The union of two non-regular sets is not regular. And infinite union of finite set is regular. Can anybody answer this? Somebody answered too. Okay, who is Shubham? Shubham, Saurabh. Every finite subset of a non-regular set is regular. Finite subset of a non-regular set is regular. Yes. So this is a great question. You can again practice them properly. Okay. Just a minute, let me see. Where is the regular expression thing? Yes, so here is another illustration you must understand. This is very important for your compiler designers. Okay, so regular expression can be, you know, regular expression can be represented by converted to a regular grammar. Okay, so regular grammar. So what happens basically? Many students get confused regarding, the grammar you are using in TOC to represent your regular expression, and the grammar you are using in compiler design for parsing. How they are different? You understand? When you are using in TOC some grammar to accept some language, like what is the okay, so you have some string like A, B, B. What in, you have done, you have used some grammar to generate the string A, B, B, correct? But you will say, instead of this, when you are using some grammar in compiler design, they are doing something like, term, term will be in lower position. I should say like statement to some expression, right? Expression to some digit. this kind of thing is happening, and it is going to lead you to some digits. If I say this expression after some derivation, you are getting some something like count, which is itself, string. Right. So what is the difference between them? So these grammars are called regular grammar. These grammars you are doing use here are context-free grammar. Okay, so they looks like same, but there is a little difference. Okay, so this is the thing. Then again, if you have regular expression, you can convert to DFA. You can convert to NFA. Okay, regular expression to NFA, NFA to regular expression, DFA to DFA. Okay, so you can convert to anything to other form. Okay. So this is notion to specify a language. This is declarative. We can define an algebra for regular expression. So in that algebra, the operations are union or OR. Union is given by OR. It is given by plus sign or the vertical bar. You have concatenation. I have already told you. Kinetic laser is there and positive star is there. You know. So precedence of this, if you see, parenthesis is having the highest precedence, then clinic closure, then concatenation, then union. Okay. Definition of regular expression. So regular expression R is defined like this. R equal to A for some A in alphabet epsilon starting. Standing for the regular expression L to A. Sorry, for the language L to A. Okay, so like this, R is empty and standing for language L to empty string only. Then R is equal to 5 standing for empty language. So you understand what is difference between empty string, a language, having only empty string, and a language having no string. So there is difference, right? Then if R1 and R2 are regular expression, then we can do a R between them. Okay, so plus sign is R, basically plus or you can write the vertical bar. Okay, or you can concatenate them, you can have a clinic closure. Okay, sorry. And you can have a parenthesis. Okay. Some examples are given here. If you have a regular expression like this, if you have a regular expression like this, then you have this kind of strings. Okay. So, here are some more examples. You can see here. This is a regular expression for language. Then you have only these four strings. It can give you, empty string. That means, this part is basically, the first part is basically zero or epsilon. So you have produced epsilon from here. Concatenation, one or epsilon, the second part. So from here also you have generated epsilon. So epsilon concatenation epsilon will give you epsilon. So epsilon is one of the string can be generated. Okay. Now from this first part you have generated zero, and from the second part you have generated epsilon. Then zero concatenation epsilon will give you zero. Okay, so zero can be another string produced. Okay, then say from the first part you have generated epsilon, from the second part you have generated one, so epsilon concatenation one will give you one. So one is possible to generate. Okay, Another thing can happen, you from the first part you generate zero, from the second part you generate one. So zero concatenated with one, it is gives you 0 1. So 0 1 is another string possible here. Yeah. No other string is possible, you can check it out. Okay. So equivalence of finite automata and regular expression, this is what we are discussing, right? So for all sorry, there exists a finite automata for any regular expression. Okay, so we can convert regular expression to epsilon NFA, since epsilon NFA can be converted to DFA, and DFA can again converted to NFA. You know, they are convertible, so it can be proved also. The problem going into all this proof and all. Okay, so there is a method called state elimination method. You know, for doing this conversion from NFA to DFA, and there is other method also we'll discuss, because this is very important part of our syllabus, converting NFA to DFA. Then DFA to regular expression is another part. Okay, so this thing we will discuss slowly. Okay, so I think do you have anything to say, any question from your side?